Prayers and Meditations, page 94. March 10, 1914. In the silence of the night, thy peace reign over all things. In the silence of my heart, thy peace reigns always. And when these two silences are united, thy peace was so powerful that no disturbance of any kind could resist it. Then I thought of all those who were watching over the boat to safeguard and protect our course, and in gratefulness I wanted to make thy peace spring up and live in their hearts. Then I thought of all those who, confident and free from care, slept the sleep of inconscience, and with solicitude for their miseries, pity for their latent suffering which would arise in them when they awoke, I wanted that a little of thy peace might live in their hearts and awaken in them the life of the spirit, the light that dispels ignorance. Then I thought of all the inhabitants of this vast sea, both visible and invisible, and I willed that thy peace might spread over them. Then I thought of those we had left far behind and whose affection goes with us, and with a great tenderness I wanted thy conscious and lasting peace for them, the plenitude of thy peace as far as they could receive it. Then I thought of all those towards whom we are going, who are troubled by childish preoccupations and fight in ignorance and egoism for petty rivalries of interest, and ardently, in a great aspiration, I asked for them the full light of thy peace. Then I thought of all those we know, all those we do not know, all the life in the making, all that has changed its form, all that is not yet in form, and for all these, even as for all that I cannot think about, for all that is present to my memory, and for all that I forget, in a deep contemplation and mute adoration, I implore thy peace.